Cheryl McDuff, what's the best insulin resistance test? That's a great question. Glad you asked. Here's the standard, hemoglobin A1C. Lots of problems with hemoglobin A1C. It'll go up or down 15% or more on a regular basis. It's also impacted by red blood cells, the lifespan of them, both of which have nothing to do with your glucose metabolism. Before that, doctors were looking at fasting glucose. Both of these have significant problems. And you know that estimate where the CDC says there are 80 million Americans with insulin resistance and 72 million don't know about it? That was done entirely with hemoglobin A1C and fasting glucose. A couple of years ago, UCLA came out with a study saying, you know what, in California at least, it's not a third of adults age 60 and older, like the CDC says. It's 50%, over 50% of adults in California. And guess what? It's not just starting at age 60, it's starting at age 30. Over 50% of the adults in California have prediabetes. Glad you don't live in California, huh? I don't think it's just California. UCLA study also was done using fasting glucose and hemoglobin A1C. You cannot understand your carbohydrate metabolism unless you look at it and challenge it. There's another study that a study test that a lot of people say, oh, do the HOMA-IR. Bottom line, none of these work well unless you actually challenge the glucose. HOMA-IR is based on a static ratio between insulin and blood sugar levels, and that's not adequate. I've seen those things look like they were normal in people that had full-blown diabetes. You have to do what's called an oral glucose tolerance test. You fast, you take a glucose level and an insulin level. You take a 75-gram or 100-gram challenge with glucose, and then you check your glucose and insulin over the next hour, 2 hours, and with some of them, up to 4 hours. That shows you exactly how your body handles glucose, carbohydrates. The more definitive one with the 4 hours and looking at both insulin and glucose is called the Kraft Insulin Survey. That one also uses the higher amount, 100 grams of glucose. So the bottom line is, maybe I went too far, too fast, too many details. Again, we're very passionate, as you can see, about helping people recognize this problem, and we can help you get there. 859-721-1414. So I'd like to talk with you a minute about the webinar. People don't understand what the webinar is. It's actually a great way to get some access to healthcare that you're just not going to get any other way. You actually get the lab tests yourself at a local lab, a Quest lab near you, for the inflammation panel and the OGTT and the insulin survey. These are things, inflammation and prediabetes, that your doctor just does not know about. And here's the thing. Harvard Health and many others have said, look, sudden death is not always so sudden. The Hollywood picture that it's a bolt out of the blue is not realistic. It's more like real lightning preceded by clouds, wind, and rain. Stop that metabolic storm before the lightning strikes. And here's where that metabolic storm comes from. It's inflammation, and it has to do usually with prediabetes. So again, we actually get labs. We go over them in the webinar, and then you can start finding out how you can prevent that heart attack others said that you couldn't even predict. We can show you how. Thanks.